This week on Burnout, the ultimate drag race challenge. Will a trip to the track keep blue team's momentum going? Or will they fail and bail? And the challenge is on for Chops to lead, follow, or get out of the way.
Chops, step outside for a moment, please.
Previously on Burnout,
the two final winners are James and Wyatt.
I love the kid to death, but I don't think he's the right person in the seat.
My in-face test, I definitely bombed. If I end up bombing again, I can't keep going.
Well, we really need to get a game plan, though, Chops.
If there's nothing to be done, there's nothing to be done.
It's time to build a car here, and the goof around time is over.
Take the trash out, Chops.
I'm busy doing this.
Ain't doing.
Everybody, go home.
We wanted to give him a second chance.
Let's give him a week to change.
If we don't start seeing improvement as a team, we would decide something else to do.
Oh, my back hurts. My back hurts.
Your back hurts? I don't want you driving my car.
It's in my butt hurts.
Today we're welding in the roll cage and I'm taking a beating. I hope this protects me better at the track.
Hey, flip my switch.
Things should be fine. John's a really good welder, and he's done this kind of stuff before. But enough about us. We're ahead of schedule.
Damn it.
The only thing anyone wants to talk about is the blue team.
They're not organized, and they don't seem as organized. Exactly.
Especially Mr. Chops.
They're gonna mutiny against Chops?
No, I'm not even joking. That's what I heard.
So what are they gonna do, kill him?
No, not kill him.
Just say, hey, stop being you.
I guess they gave him some kind of week-long time frame to kind of straighten his act out and become an actual leader. You know, it's probably not gonna happen. He seems like a stubborn type.
Oh, or let me finish. Sorry, sorry.
If they vote on it, Chops is gonna be chopped.
How much power does Chops really have?
None.
So if Chops told me to be here at 3 in the morning, I'd be like, shut the hell up and be here at 8.
The roll cage came in today, and the plan is to get it tacked into place.
Stop crying like a girl because it's heavy.
Last week, we had the issue with Chops. As a team, we really just didn't feel like he was really contributing. Today, he was doing the same thing. He just wants to stand around and look at what you're doing. There's only so much you can watch.
Once we tack it, we are going to have to whack it a few. Hey, that rhymes.
He seems to lack organization sometimes.
We really need to get a game plan, though, Chops.
Kind of whatever it takes to be a leader, he's just not on it. I think Richard would be a good crew chief.
So the straps come up around like that.
He's the de facto chief right now. He built a custom mount for our fuel cell and tackled most of the bodywork himself. We were talking about, what do you see happening with this car? And he goes, well, if I were the crew chief and this is, and then he started owning it. He was gonna break up the team into three smaller teams, front, middle, and rear. Basically, a Henry Ford assembly line.
If we can funnel them into a direction as a team together, we'll be able to knock this thing out, no problem.
Right now, the only problem is what to do about Chops. We're putting all this work in and you're taking days off, whether it's you're sick or you're tired or you gotta get parts for your motorcycle.
Chops went to go get parts for his motorcycle. He'll be back after a bit.
Okay.
It's a 95 Super Glide. Just looking cool and feeling good. Love the ape hangers. Easy Rider's my favorite movie. Late 60s, early 70s, 3/4 helmet. Right now, what's wrong is the ignition control module went out. I've been waiting on a replacement for weeks, and it finally came in today. It was a quick fix, so I figured Blue Team could wait a few hours.
Corey, I just remembered I have a UPS box sitting at my house. I'm gonna go pick it up.
Let's go get parts for your motorcycle.
Hey, let's just stay busy. Let's stay focused on the task at hand. Come on.
You can go home. I don't care. I'm gonna stay here and work.
I'm all about second chances. He's completely burning his second chance as we speak.
Coming up next on Burnout.
Let's race.
The team that completes the most laps in those 30 minutes will be the winner.
Cut him off.
Red team was playing a little dirty out there. They ran Wyatt right into the barriers.
We told both teams to report bright and early to Bondurant for a big surprise.
We got out to Bondurant pretty early and didn't really know what was going to happen.
Everyone was kind of disagreeing with me, but I knew the whole time there was going to be a damn challenge. I'm like, why else would we be going out there?
Teams, today's challenge, you will all be driving go-karts. But none of you will be driving go-karts like this. They will be racing carts like this.
We got two pedals in this cart, the gas on the right, and the brake is on the left. As far as getting these things to go around the track fast, it's best just to be on the gas when you want to, be on the brake when you need to. Just make sure you don't use them at the same time.
These carts are fast. They do about 60 miles an hour. The only thing slowing you down is weight. Looking at the red team, I think we got this.
Blue team, you're gonna win this challenge.
I didn't fit.
Tuck it under.
It was definitely painful on my butt.
As far as our equipment goes, helmets, head socks, and jackets.
Who are you?
Sperm Man.
Yes, there you go. You gotta have that reservoir.
All right, guys, today's challenge is pretty simple. We're splitting each team into groups of five. We're gonna run an endurance race of 30 minutes. The team that completes the most laps in those 30 minutes will be the winner. Every team member must make at least four laps, which means you'll be making four pit stops. Bondurant Karting Challenge is a team-building process.
I can do as many laps as you guys need.
Okay.
With the crew chief making the decision whether to leave a driver out there longer or not.
If you're feeling fatigued at all, don't try to be a hero. Give us a tap. Let us know.
You strategize. Who's my strongest driver? Who do I want out there the most?
One of our best drivers first, and save one for last. This way we had one guy hauling ass.
Red team on three. One, two, three. Red team!
Red team, we want to beat them really, really good, and we're just going to...
Blue team! If I get a chance, somebody's getting spun out.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's race. Yeah. It was a Le Mans start. Four drivers laying on the ground. When we said go, they hop up, get in their carts, and take off.
Danielle was driving like Danica. She was hauling ass through there. But she didn't think about one of the turns and full throttle into this barrier. Wow! Didn't let it phase her. She got right back in the race, got back on the course, kept going. The next lap around, she did the same thing again. She hit the brakes a little too late. Slam!
Some of the people thought they could drive. They can't.
So if you're spinning out and leaving the track with your car and hitting barriers and just doing dumb you're going to lose time and lose those laps.
Let's go!
Got this.
Come on, red team. You drag it up the rear.
Having to pit and change drivers, it's all about time. You spin out, you just lost. It might be even a lap.
Driver change.
After our first pit stop, we had a two-lap lead, and Big John still has to drive.
Come on, smooth. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Absolutely love that place. Tokyo drifted around one of those whole corners. It's like,
I pretty much knew going into this that we weren't gonna get the same time as the rest of them, so. It was still fun for me to go around four or five times, you know, but if we're gonna make up laps, it's up to James.
Pretty much passed everybody that was on the track with me at the time. I saw that the blue team pitted both of their guys at the same time. As soon as I saw that, it was like tracks to myself, feeling good.
He got the blue team out front, but right now, little James is pouring it on.
There is a lot of spin-outs.
I think I got actually spun out by James as he was trying to overtake me.
Sorry, Quincy.
Hey, watch each other, boys! Spun me out.
After some more pits, crashes, and spins, time was running out.
5 minutes left!
It all came down to Wyatt versus Victor.
Wyatt just kept bumping me, trying to pass me, and I just wouldn't let him pass me.
You my boy, Blue! Hit him off!
Rubbin's racing, I guess.
We went around again, and Wyatt was doing the exact same thing. Kept bumping me, kept bumping me, kept bumping me.
Come on, Wyatt, get him.
Get him, get him!
So we took that turn, I took it wide again, stupid of me, and he took it on the inside, and I was like, screw it, go big or go home. So I just rammed him right in the rear.
Red team was playing a little dirty out there. They ran Wyatt right into the barriers. He was braking, and boom.
Sure enough, they black flagged me off the thing. He pulled me into the pitch. He's like, you know why I pulled you in here? I'm like, yeah, I know why.
There goes your 20 bucks.
Wyatt got put into the wall by one of the red team members. They got black flagged and penalized, and that pretty much guaranteed us the race right there.
We actually won one.
Blue team, for winning today's challenge, I'm awarding you 10 hours. Yeah! Woo! Red team, you have lost 10 hours.
Yeah! Well, they needed it.
I had a good time. I actually want to go back to that place and see if they want to just let me in and do some driving. If they ask for any money, we got a problem.
Coming up next on Burnout.
Read the damn test first before you answer any question.
He's failing.
Pressure's starting to cook everybody. We're starting to see the true colors come out.
You're worth it. You can do this.
And then we'll get new management.
Ha-ha.
That sucks.
There are keywords in questions that you have to look for. It's a very tricky test. We switch it around a little bit to confuse you a little bit, like an ASE test. All the answers are on the test, yes. You just gotta go eeny, meeny, miny, mo, whatever.
My end phase test, I definitely bombed. I was not happy about that. If I end up bombing again, I can't keep going.
I don't want her to leave the team. She needs to stay. We'll see how that goes. Hopefully she does good on her test.
How do you get your head in the test? Read the damn test first before you answer any question. I'm grading them immediately. They're not going anywhere. So don't be worried about the date. You want to know what the date is? Today is the day after yesterday.
Several team members already tested. Some did better than expected.
I did 100% on that one this morning. I was pretty surprised.
I aced my test, yeah!
Others, not so much.
Failed my test.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Pressure's starting to cook everybody. We're starting to see the true colors come out.
I'm stressed out. I hate failing.
I don't know if a lot of people are gonna be able to hack it.
I graded her fairly. She pushed herself into a corner. Students do that. They put more pressure on themselves than them when they fail. We're there to put the pieces back together. Some of them just run away. I kind of watch these young kids. I'm kind of like a dad. I don't want them to know I have a heart. Justine, look at me. Don't put so much pressure on yourself.
This one?
You're worth it. You can do this. Kid puts too much pressure on herself.
I can't do it anymore.
That sucks.
I just saw Justine after she took her final. She definitely failed.
So I'm not gonna be able, I'm gonna talk to everybody about it.
As far as blue team goes, I think she just bailed.
Today we are completing Oak Cage installation. Basically done now, John's putting in the last plate.
Also working on a little bit of aesthetics. We got fenders and bumper and everything mocked up just so we can really see what it's gonna be like. I think it's gonna be real nice.
Looks pretty good, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Pounding ground.
After we finished up, me and Quincy went over and snuck a peek at the blue team's roll cage. They just kind of slapped it together, and it's not really good.
Good luck with that.
These cars are going to have to go through pre-track inspection, and if your welds look like they're not going to let you run. Especially when you're running a 10-second car, and we're talking death.
I just don't want it to go down the track like a pretzel. We were just talking about the integrity of the cage. Do we order another half cage? Do we just leave it as is, or you know what to do? Stuff happens. I've seen it happen. I've been at a drag race and seen a car go on its roof. My aunt and uncle own a fabrication shop in Phoenix, and they've offered to fix all the welds if we can get the car there. To get it to the shop, we're gonna have to have the rear end. We're gonna have to have the coilovers in the front. The only other option is to freaking pick it up and move it.
Just looking at our cars, you can really tell we're a lot farther than they are.
In order to complete the build, something has to change dramatically now. It may be a group decision too. Why don't we get the whole team together? We'll decide if Chops gets demoted. Will he quit? I really don't know.
We'll go from there.
And then get new management.
We had our daily meeting and Chop starts listing a plan for the rest of the build. Seems like it's a little late for that now.
What's up? What's up, Justine?
Then Justine throws a wrench into our game plan.
You know, it's cool to be on TV, but grades are way more important to me right now. So is schoolwork, so I'm going to quit.
What do you do in a situation like that?
We already have lost Justine, partially lost Brandon to school issues right now.
I hate failing.
It worries me to lose another.
You may not be a part of this team officially anymore, but you can stop by anytime.
I miss you guys. You guys are my boys.
Liar.
You're still part of this team.
Yep. Thank you.
And Chops is still the chief, for now.
Insert sad music.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Coming up next on Burnout.
Y'all gonna try to test before paint? If one of those cars shows up unpainted, I'm gonna be pissed.
Well, I'll make sure I'll piss you off before we get to the track, dude.
I know y'all had a secret meeting. I know what it was about.
Chop, step outside for a moment, please.
I don't remember the rest of the words of that song. It's like, desire. She's got dirty back, not sexy back.
With some help from my towel, Danielle actually had some back today, and we got our block back, so everybody wins. Before we start initial assembly, we have to make sure we have all of our parts and everything we need is here and ready.
Inspection, sir.
We're making sure whenever it goes together and we drop it in the car, it is a pristine machine. Back at the shop, Clay stopped by for a surprise visit.
Happy where we at or no?
What's that?
Time-wise, clock. Y'all gonna try to test before paint? When I mentioned the word paint to John, he got real quiet.
I'm more worried about getting it done with leaving us time to practice.
The paint and body place that got set up for us is on the opposite side of town from us, and that's gonna be 4 or 5 days worth of work.
Painting is part of this whole process. If one of those cars shows up at the racetrack unpainted, I'm gonna be pissed.
Well, I'll make sure I'll piss you off before we get to the track, then.
Show me some of your welding, bro. Red Team has an 8-point cage, 8 attaching points inside the car, which strengthens it up, makes it safer, makes it a better race car.
Yeah, it's gonna be plenty strong.
It'll be strong. I used to weld roll cages for rhinos. Every time we had an accident, the metal would kink before my welds would break. Yeah.
Blue Team put in a 6-point cage. I don't know that the way they put it in is the best that it could be done. I'm hoping that they go back and do a few more things before we really bust them out on that, but
right now we are busting their chops about something else.
All right, guys, you know, Corey's uncle owns a welding shop in town. We might go from a 6-point to a 8 or 10-point. Get this car really stiff.
Hey, Clay. What's up, Clay?
I know y'all had a secret meeting. I know what it was about. Chop, step outside for a moment, please.
The vote to get Chops removed went a little bit more dramatically than I thought it was going to.
No one stepped forward to make this happen, so I felt it was my job to put him on the spot. Chops crew chief, yes or no?
I'd say he's been doing a lot better.
That's a yes.
No.
No.
Yes.
Richard.
It's something that needed to happen, and I'm glad it happened.
Majority rules, it was way landslide.
We have an answer. Now, still on the team, yes or no?
Yes.
Who's crew chief?
I got my vote on Fonz.
Fonz.
Do you want this job?
Yeah, I'll take this job.
You're working. I like that.
In my perfect world, we still have him on the team to be part of the build, part of everything like it's supposed to be.
Everybody here loves you, but they want to have Richard become the crew chief. They just feel that Richard's been a little more hands-on, a little more leadership role. We want you to take one for the team, and we need your hand. We need your help. Are you staying?
Yeah, I'll probably stay.
Good answer.
I was more concerned with the clock than the team and the build for a while there, so I was kind of not letting anybody do anything. But, you know, with this last week, with getting the hours, getting everything lined up, a lot has changed.
I am proud that you're part of this team. Let's just get this car built, guys.
It's going to work, guys.
First thing I noticed when I went into the Blue Team's work area, Richard had the whole team reorganizing, cleaning. That was his first move, and I loved it. I love a clean race shop.
We took a few minutes out of our time to stop, clean the whole shop, put like parts with other like parts. Now you can walk up to that bench and find anything you want.
Richard seems to be quickly stepping into the role of crew chief and taking over.
I've worked with them all as a worker and actually become friends with everyone here. So I want to put out a product that not only is going to look awesome, but it's going to kick ass down the way, you know?
Right on.
And that's the goal.
I also like the fact that Chops was right in there cleaning up with him.
We definitely gained an extra hand. I think it's good for the team.
I would rather have Fonzie as a crew chief than an Elvis impersonator. Especially a fat Elvis.
The Chops. They're probably not gonna go away.
I'm actually starting to get a little intimidated now that they got Fonzie. He's got him squared away. He's one of us, you know, like he's a rat rotter. You know, he likes old stuff, he likes classics, you know. He's Fonzie.
Now that Richard is the crew chief, I'm a little worried about the Blue Team. With some good leadership, they can be dangerous.
Next time on Burnout, the ultimate drag race challenge.
I got Chop Dandruff.
I don't care about paint. Paint does not make the car go any faster.
Challenge!
You guys ready for the next challenge?
Yeah!
Are we?
Two guys are gonna change the tire. The other two are gonna bring the tire back and put the tire on.
You screw this up, you won't be driving your car. I will.
I don't know how to drive that car.
I just don't think he's got the balls to do it.